Hi, I'm Scotty, and this is the Imagine Neighborhood. This week on the show, there's a carnival in town. There's all kinds of cool stuff at the carnival, but something about this one just doesn't seem quite right. We're going to put together all of our problem-solving skills to get to the bottom of this scuba-rific mystery. All that plus one of my favorite songs of all time, A Mysterious Tub of Purple Goo, and the return of Jody the Roadie. Welcome back to the Imagine Neighborhood. Hey, everybody. I cannot wait for this. Today, we are going to a carnival.
Oh, yeah, a carnival.
There's going to be rides.
And popcorn on the ground.
And games.
And deep-fried candy bars on the ground.
It's going to be a good time.
Even though it's kind of scary to be out of the house.
Hey, Vec, I am so proud of you for coming out here today. I know it's a little scary for you, but I'm really glad you're here.
Me too. I'm a little scared, but... Oh, boy. I'm going to score so much half-eaten food.
I'll take your word for it. Oh, look at this line. All these people waiting to get in? I guess that means it's a really great carnival. Really great carnival.
At last. Greetings, listeners. I bet you thought you were about to hear another humdrum episode of the Imagine Neighborhood today, with Scotty and his whiny little friends talking about their feelings. Well, think again, smarty pants. These episodes haven't been talking about me very much, and it's high time we fix that. So I've hacked into the feed of this crummy little podcast. Today, the one you shall listen to is me, Tantrumus Maximus. That mop-top paper towel cube Scotty and his jumpy little mechanical minion are about to enter my carnival. Too bad they're in for an unpleasant time. Starting with the impossibly slow line to enter the fairgrounds. Let's have a look, shall we? Alexa, focus the spy camera.
Yeesh, that line really was not moving. Well, good thing we've got lots of things to do to make waiting more fun. Anyway, hey, we're here.
Yeah, and... Holy circuits. It's magical. There's stale popcorn and cold french fries. And... melted purple snow cones! Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh!
Well, Vec seems like he'll be busy for a while. Maybe I could, Oh, here, I'll go on this ride instead. Okay, it's the Brain Masher. Sounds fun. I hope. Okay, well, we have, let's see, this is a voice-activated automated ticket booth. Neat. All right, okay. One ticket, please.
Please insert $10.
$10? Jeez, okay.
Please insert $10.
Another $10? Oh man, maybe it didn't work the first time. I guess I'll, let me try again.
Please insert $10.
Hey, you're supposed to give me a ticket. Now I can't even go on the ride.
No refunds. No refunds. No refunds.
Well, that is really, I mean, that stinks. I'm just going to take a deep breath and calm down. Whew. Okay, that's better. Oh, hey, Vec.
Hi, Scotty. This is paradise, man. Oh, my gosh. I followed a bag of peanuts under a bench, and I found a mountain of cotton candy. And now I can see through time.
That's great, buddy. Hey, have you noticed anything a little fishy about this carnival?
Fish? No. Deep fried ice cream? Yes! You wouldn't believe what I've been finding on the ground here.
Yeah, it's like people got so fed up they threw their fruit on the ground and left.
I know! I mean, look over there! Oh, a dire corn dog!
What? That infuriating little toothpick man! Why isn't he taking the bait? That no refund stunt drives everyone berserk! After all, getting discombobulated by the long line to get in, he was set up for a monumental tantrum! I need everyone at this carnival to become a furious, tantruming brute, and this knucklehead won't cooperate. What's this? He's in line for a candy apple. One of my most devious schemes. Let's zoom in and watch the meltdown, shall we?
Wow, this line sure is long. Wow, we've been waiting for a long time in this long line. Are you sure you need a candy apple? Because, oh, look over there, there's corn chips. Hey, by the way, I got a great idea for a business.
I'm sure. It's not a carnival without a candy apple, you know?
Yeah, okay, whatever, candy apples. Ooh, you're in the front of the line. All right, I'll be under that bench eating that fried watermelon if you need me. Bye!
Ooh, yes, okay. One candy apple, please.
Welcome to the concession stand. Please state your order.
One candy apple, please?
I heard. Corn. Dog. Is that correct?
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I am having trouble understanding you. For mustard, please say mustard. For ketchup, please say ketchup.
No. Incorrect. I just want a candy apple.
I heard you say ketchup.
What?
Is that correct?
No! Ketchup on a corn dog? Look, lady, I'm from Chicago and I'm sorry. I just want a candy apple.
If you'd like to change your order, please say change order.
Look, I just want a candy. Weasel whiskers on a pogo stick. This is infuriating.
Scotty?
What?
Are you okay?
No. I mean, yes. I mean, man, I was all excited for a candy apple, and this robot thingy is just really frustrating.
Yeah, robots sure can be buggy sometimes. I should know. I am one. But we're all just trying our best.
Yeah. You're right, Vac. I shouldn't lose my temper like that. I guess I just make things right.
Make things right. Cool. Okay, how?
Well, if you got upset with someone, you need to apologize and talk about what happened. I'm sorry, concession stand robot. I was upset and I shouldn't have yelled.
Welcome to the concession stand.
Yeah. But man, something is really weird about this carnival.
Yeah. Getting upset like this really isn't like you. Usually you're the one telling me to calm down.
Yeah, hey, you're right. There's something about this place. It's like they've built the whole thing just to upset people.
Why would anyone do that?
But why would they? Oh my gosh. Vac, I think I know what's going on here. This whole carnival is...
Scotty! Hey, Scotty! That trap door opened and you fell down the hole before you could tell me what was going on! Are you gonna tell me or what? Scotty? Hello? Oh no. He's gone! Oh, what do I do? Okay. This is a big, scary problem, but it's gonna be okay. I learned what to do. The first step is to calm down. I can definitely do that. A nice, slow breath in through the nose, or the vent, out through the mouth. Whew. Okay. The next step is to say the problem. The problem is, Scotty just disappeared down that hole and I need to get him back! And then, I think of solutions. Okay, I can use if-then to help me. So, if I jump down the hole, then I'll crash land. And I don't think that'll be very helpful. Oh, I know, if. I think I got it. But I'm going to need some backup. Okay, listeners, I need to go into the forest for a minute. Could you talk to your grown-up like Scotty always asks you to do? Did you ever have a problem that was so big that you needed to go get help to fix it? Sometimes when you have a big, scary problem, you need extra determination. That means being very, very, very sure of what you need to do. Like in this song. This song is called One Way or Another by Blondie. And it's all about being determined to find somebody. And that's exactly what I gotta do. We'll be right back to the Imagine Neighborhood. Okay, bye.
One way or another, I'm gonna find you. I'm gonna get you one way or another. I'm gonna win you. I'm gonna get you one way or another. I'm
Welcome back, listeners. Oh, you were expecting your pal Scotty, were you? Or his brave little toaster friend? Every single week, that frosted flake gets your undivided attention. Scotty, Scotty, Scotty. Well, not today, you little pests. 'Cause I'm the one talking now.
Oh, my head. Tantrumus who? What? How many? Where am I?
Ah, I see the little bay leaf in my minestrone is awake. Your yapping days are over, Nimrod. Starting now, we fill your listeners' ears with the voice of Tantrumus Maximus.
Tantrumus Maximus? So this is your carnival? But where are you, and why am I chained to this big machine filled with purple goo?
So many questions. Quite frankly, you little walking windsock man, you are getting too close to figuring out my dastardly plan.
Yeah, you built a lousy carnival to make everybody upset, which is extremely... not nice.
Yes, marvelous. Keep getting angry, my boy.
It's got lousy rides and crummy games, and worst of all, your candy apple machine is rotten.
Why, thank you. Makes you just seethe with anger, doesn't it?
Yeah, you better believe it. I've got a good mind to... Hey, what is that purple goo doing?
Oh, that? Why, it's just, feeding off all your negative energy. Every bad mood at this carnival lands here, in my bad vibulator. The worse you feel, the higher it grows, and the more powerful I become.
You'll never get away with this.
Oh, won't I? Just wait until every nincompoop above ground has the nastiest tantrum of the year. When this tank is full, I shall drink the solution and have the most epic tantrum the world has ever seen. And then I shall eat this enormous cake to celebrate.
That is one enormous cake. Wait. Why would you want to have a tantrum?
You silly mop top. The apple of everyone's eardrums. Of course you wouldn't understand. When I have my epic tantrum, everyone will finally stop listening to you and pay attention to me. Me!
But wait. You don't need to throw a tantrum to get people to pay attention to you.
You're just saying that because you didn't think of it first. It's my plan, and it's foolproof. You think you can stop me? No one can stop me!
Don't bet on it!
Vac, you're here, and you're dangling from the ceiling.
I'm here, and I'm tied to a sock.
That doesn't explain anything.
Oh, holding on to the sock above me is a whole chain of sock goblins. And they're all hanging on to each other. And there's a gremlin hanging on to the sock goblins. And an ogre hanging on to the gremlin. Jody the roadie hanging on to the ogre. And the one Ionian cockatiel.
Ah, I got the chains.
Woo! Thanks. Being chained up was giving me a cramp. Vac, how'd you do all this?
Well, I got pretty nervous when you just disappeared through that trapdoor. But then, I calmed down and solved the problem, just like we talk about. And then I used if then to help me think of some solutions. And that helped me figure out that I needed to ask for help. So I ran into the middle of the forest and I yelled, "Scotty needs help!" And all these critters just came out of the trees and the mountains and the lava beds and stuff. They said that you had helped them and they wanted to help you. And we heard all about his evil plan and we came to stop it.
How did you hear about his evil plan?
The microphone you used for the podcast was on the whole time. Anyway, we found the trapdoor and came down the hole and here we are.
Oh, that's amazing, Vac, and so brave. I'm so proud of you.
Stop that! Stop that! Both of you! All of you! KitchenAid, go back to where you came from! You're destabilizing the bad mood elixir!
Oh, sorry about that. We just came down to get Scotty.
Stop apologizing, you little nitwit. You're supposed to be tiny and afraid. I left you a year's worth of garbage up in that fairground. You could have just stayed up there and eaten moldy funnel cake to your little mechanical heart's content.
Oh, yeah, I could have. I do love moldy funnel cake. But you're not seeing my point of view. I might have stayed up there if I only knew how to think about myself.
Well, don't you?
No! I had to come and rescue Scotty. Because he's my friend, and that's what friends do.
You clumsy little overgrown pocket watch. My bad mood goo can't handle all this goodwill.
Maybe to stop Tantrumus Maximus, we have to think like Tantrumus Maximus.
What? How dare you? No one thinks like me. I'm a singular sensation.
We can switch a room with him.
That's a great idea, Vac.
You noodle-headed raisin brains. This glop here is a highly volatile substance. It understands one thing only. Collecting everyone's negative energy. Your despicably unselfish rescue operation has destabilized it enough already.
So, we're thinking about Mr. Tantrumus hiding away behind a microphone somewhere.
It must be really hard to feel invisible like that.
No, no! You stop seeing things from my point of view right now!
Well, look, you don't have to switcheroo with us if you don't want to. It's okay if the answer is no.
Good grief!
But that doesn't mean we can't switcheroo with you. So, we're thinking about Tantrumus Maximus and how he sees the situation, and we're going to try to take his point of view. Ready to switcheroo?
Ready!
What?
Oh, no.
Two.
Alexa, stop them!
Switcheroo! Oh my gosh, Vac. Wow, you and your whole chain of critters just fell down the hole. Are you okay?
Oh yeah, we're fine. We landed in this cake. Mmm, sticky but delicious.
Did you see that? The goo got so excited and the whole goo machine just exploded.
Yeah. Is Tantrumus Maximus okay?
I don't know, but hey, do you hear something over where that machine was?
Yeah, I hear that too. It's like a
Here, it's coming from over here. Here, will you help me lift this up?
Oh, hey, it's a little hamster?
What a world, what a world. My glorious tantrum machine in ruins.
Tantrumus, are you okay?
I am not okay. You louts have loused up my magnificent diabolical plans.
That sounds really hard.
It is. It is hard. I worked for months on that machine.
I'm sure you did. It must feel really bad to have it destroyed. Do you want to talk about it?
All right, fine. I'll talk about it.
Okay, do you need a hand getting out of there?
Yes, in fact, I do. Lift me out of this disconcerting debris and I'll tell you about my feeling.
Yep, I'll just lift you out.
Bring me a little closer so you can hear me.
And I'll bring you a little closer and...
Ha! Eye poke!
Ow! My eye! That's just...
Fools! Trying to get me to learn my lesson? I never learn. But I'll be back. And you'll rue the day you ever crossed Tantrumus Maximus!
Huh. He didn't want to talk about it.
That's okay. Maybe he'll want to talk next time. People aren't always ready to be the best version of themselves.
He said he'd come back. So I guess we'll get to see him again sometime.
Yeah, and hey, Vac, you did an amazing job today.
Oh, thanks, homie.
I've got a serious hankering for a candy apple now, though.
And now I'm craving moldy funnel cake.
Hey, what if we go home and make some carnival food? Maybe we can make some games, too.
Ooh, and you can throw more food on the ground for me.
Yeah, hey, I should call up Doc and Macho and Princess Dinosaurus and... Yeah, you guys can come too. I think I've got enough apples for everybody. Oh, hey, Vac, did you happen to make a plan for how to get us all out of here?
Oh yeah. Let me just tie this sock around your waist. Here we go. And grappling hook!
Okay, well, while Vac yoinks us all back up to ground level, I was thinking about how we put all of our problem-solving skills together today. Calming down and saying the problem, and if then, and asking for help, and switcherooing, and everything. We added them up all together, one at a time, and everything just worked out. It's kind of like this song. It's called Higher and Higher by Jackie Wilson. Can you hear how it starts with those low bass notes, and then I think a tambourine kicks in there, and then a piano, and then by the time the drums and the singer jump in, the whole collection just feels like magic. Yeah, that's what I'm feeling right now.
Up the daisy!
Oop, here we go. The Imagine Neighborhood is aligned with the award-winning social-emotional learning curriculum Second Step, produced by Committee for Children. For over 40 years, Committee for Children has worked toward helping everyone grow kinder. Mia Dosis is our executive producer, Nicole Richardson, our story editor, and editing this week by me. For more information about the show, you can go to imagineneighborhood.org. Grown-ups, you can find our daily adventures, learn more about the research behind every episode, or get in touch. Let us know what you think. Hey, thank you so much for joining us today. I'm really glad you listened. We're going to keep the song playing while you talk. But until next time, I'm Scotty E. Siri. And if you do go to imagineneighborhood.org, send me a note. I want to know. How are you kind today? Be kind to each other out there.